The reason why Jesus never went into the most holy place is because he was not from the tribe of Levi. He was not a Levitical priest, so he could not go into the most holy place. So that's why the Bible says that when he ascended, he went into the most holy place that was not built with hands, that was not made with hands. And the saints on earth, the disciples, and those in Hades, they eagerly awaited for him to come out of the most holy place and to announce that salvation was now there. And the Bible talks about in Hebrew, see, those that were called from Genesis to Revelation, those who were called, the disciples, the old covenant saints, they were waiting eagerly for that promised eternal inheritance. And then it continues. Therefore, it was necessary that the copies of these things in the heavens should be purified with these, but the heavenly things themselves with better sacrifices than these. For Christ has not entered the holy place made with hands. See, Christ never went into the temple, the most holy place in the temple, which are the copies of the true, but the heaven itself. See, the old covenant temple on earth was a copy of the true heaven. And now to appear in the presence of God for us, for them in the first century, Christ went up into the most holy place to appear, to offer his blood, sacrifice for their sin. And it says, not that he should offer himself often, as the high priest enters the most holy place every year with blood of another. He then would have had to suffer often since the foundation of the world. But now, once at the end of the age, the end of the old covenant age, he has appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. And as it is appointed for men to die once, but after this, the judgment, so Christ was offered once. You hear that, Catholics? Christ was offered once. Stop putting him on that cross at your communion. He was offered once for sin. To those who eagerly wait. See, the writer of Hebrews is saying, to those who eagerly wait. It was to those first century saints who was eagerly waiting for his second coming so they can inherit that promise, that eternal life. A second time, he will appear a second time, apart from sin, for salvation. So, just like when the high priest came out the temple to announce that their sin was forgiven, Yeshua, the Lamb of God, slain before the foundation of the world, came back out of heaven in judgment against old covenant Israel. He came back in judgment to announce salvation is free. You now have salvation. You now have eternal life. That temple fell. That old covenant was done away with. And that new covenant was ushered in.
And that the word of God was not written to you. Jesus was not talking to you. He was talking to his living and breathing disciples in the first century. And he told them that some of you standing here shall not taste death till you see me return in my kingdom. So you have to understand that Jesus came back in judgment against old covenant Israel. The temple fell down. Their whole heaven and earth was destroyed. It was the end of that old covenant era. Look at Hebrews. Hebrews talks about that which is waxing old is ready to burn away. What was Hebrews talking about? It was talking about the old covenant. It was waxing old and it was ready to pass away. Why? Because Yeshua was ready to come back and usher in his new covenant, his spiritual kingdom. He told his disciples, the kingdom of God is within you. He said, he told Martha, at the woman at the well, there's coming a time where man doesn't have to go to Israel to worship or to that mountain to worship. He said, those who worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. So that right there tells you It's not a physical kingdom. That is a spiritual kingdom, because God is spirit, and those who worship him in spirit and in truth. Not going to Israel, not going to the temple ruins, not going to the wailing walls and taking pictures and think you're doing something. When that temple fell, that was the end of that covenant. The new covenant was ushered in. That new Jerusalem came down. The saint of old covenant was resurrected out of Hades. And those that was on earth was given immortality. And together with the old covenant saints, they inherit that new covenant of immortality. Jesus said, he who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And he who believes in me shall never die. That covenant is a spiritual covenant. It's not a physical covenant. Jesus is not coming back in Israel and sit on the throne of David in Jerusalem where the temple once stood. And even if that temple is rebuilt again in Israel, it means nothing. And I'm going to go further to tell you that the people in Israel are not the people of God. The people in Beachwood are not the people of God. The people on Taylor are not the people of God. Only those that put their faith in Jesus. Jesus was talking to the people. He was talking to Israel, and he was trying to get them to come out of the old covenant mindset. And he said to them, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I shall give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly at heart, and ye shall find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Can you see the law to overcome the Israel? It was a heavy yoke. But Yahshua said, come unto me. He said, I shall give you rest. Sabbath. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly at heart. See, that old covenant law was a yoke of bondage. And he was coming and offering them a better way to live. Trust in me. Rely on me. Put your faith in me. No longer do you have to worry about those 613 rules, those ordinances. Trust in me, and you have fulfilled all the law. He said, behold, I give you a new commandment, to love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and all thy soul, and all thy strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. That did not believe on Jesus as the Messiah, those that did not flee to the mountains, those that did not flee to Pella, they died in their sins, or they were taken captive and sold off as slaves. But those that died, they were cast over into Gehenna. And then you look back and you see what Jesus told them, that they were going to go to hell. But the Bible, especially the King James Version, misinterpreted. It's not talking about a literal burning hell, but it was talking about Gehenna, the garbage dump outside of the gates of Jerusalem. And that's where the bodies of all the Pharisees and Sadducees and everyone else that did not believe that Yahshua was the Messiah, that's where their bodies was torn. And that, my dear, is where they burn day and night. That is the hell that the Bible is teaching on. Not a conscience tormenting hell. There is no hell. Hell is a false doctrine propagated by the Roman Catholicism Church in the 3rd century to get people to believe on the teachings they were teaching. They were frightening them to either become a Catholic or burn in hell. And then you got teachings like Dante Inferno and other teachings that help propagate that. And today we have a teaching that is of mass confusion, when the Bible simply teaches the wages of sin is death. Paul never said the wages of sin is a lake of fire. Once again, when Jesus spoke about the lake of fire, he was talking about Gehenna, the garbage dump outside of the gate.
Oh, I know you hate to hear that there's no hell. Now you say to yourself,
oh, I'm a Christian for nothing. I might as well eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow I die.
There is no hell. You're either in Christ or you're not in Christ. The wages of sin is death, separation from God. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ.
I'm asking you, I'm begging you, I'm pleading with you to just go home and read Matthew 24 and read it from their point of view. Stop putting yourself into it and read it from their point of view. And you will begin to see, if you read it with audience relevance in mind and take the time statement serious, you will see that Jesus kept his promise and he came back in judgment in AD 70 when that temple fell. It ended the old covenant age. It was a done away with old covenant Jews. And it ushered in the new kingdom of God. God bless you.